Sainsbury. I'm only looking at the tube screen.
Did you get it?
No, so well, just about. I'm only looking at the tube screen.
Welcome to Amberley TV, of course sponsored by Griffin Grays, and of course we're here with, well, I suppose one of my favourite ever Brightling City players as well, and really pleased to see that he's now having the Amberley colours on, and Tom Richardson, welcome to the club.
Thank you very much, mate.
But I mean, so how did it all come about? Because I mean, I know when we've been doing the show, the Mid-Art show, which has been with East Barrack, and...
Yeah, just what happens in football, like, funny things happen and you've just got to take it on the chin and move on. So yeah, it didn't work out at East Barrack because I'd hoped and there's other people had hoped, but yeah. And then this offer come along, so I know Webster and a few of the boys quite well, and I thought if it's to the end of the season, makes sense coming here, playing football, enjoying myself and scoring some goals hopefully.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. I suppose it'll be between you and Alex as well, I suppose, trying to nick his top goal scorer. I mean, I've had a few games left, but you never know.
On his toes, but, I've played up top with him before for Brentwood, so we know each other's game quite well and hopefully we can complement each other. As long as one of us is scoring, then I'm happy.
So is it just till the end of the season, or are you looking at a possibility of it being further?
Of course, never say never in football. Yeah. I just look at what's ahead now, and that's just getting this season finished with Amberley, finishing as high as we can, and scoring as many goals as I can, then whatever happens in the summer happens.
Magic. Well, listen, mate, we appreciate it. I know you've got to get out there for do a bit of warming up and for your holiday, so welcome to the club again, mate. Thanks for coming over.
No worries.
Welcome to Amberley TV, of course, sponsored by Griffin Grays, and we're really lucky to have with us Ryan, of course, from Amberley, and of course, the legend himself, Craig. Craig Edwards is with us as well. We'll start with Ryan. I mean, result for you, Ryan? How did you feel the game went for yourself?
One of those typical cliches, I think. It's a game of two halves. I think we played really well in the first half, obviously took our chances, and then, you know, if we hadn't scored so many goals in the first half, I think the second half would have been really holding on in the end, because to be fair to Chesson, they put us under massive pressure, and we just kept dropping and dropping and dropping. And Reece made a few good saves in goal, good few last sort of ditch tackles from the back four, and yeah, we held on for it in the end. But yeah, good result.
Yeah, pleased with home debut for Tom Richardson as well, getting a couple of
them. Yeah, he did all right, didn't he? Yeah, well, that's just what he does. You know, we had him at Bryanty last year, we know what he does, but that's why we wanted him in so well, and he'll do that for the rest of the season.
Yeah. Craig, from your point of view?
Very much what Harry said it, you know, and I was just dreadfully disappointed with us, particularly the first 20 minutes. I'm not making excuses, but we lost three of our back four. You know, sort of in the lead up to the game, one of them's gone down with flu. Then, obviously, young Jeremy's done his neck in, or it appears. And we've had to bring Roberts on him, stick Nicky in midfield. And Robbie's got slaughtered for two of the goals. Tom's murdered him. And from our point of view, they were just three dreadful goals. You know, our first half performance, well, we got what we deserved out of the game on that because we got slaughtered. And it was totally unacceptable. And I said to my assistant, is it in the second half with 20 to go, is it we've improved massively or that they've dropped off their 3-0, which could, it was, I think it was a bit of both. I think that when I watched us in the first half, we're playing balls to our forwards and they were so isolated, it was untrue. You know, Cole's trying to get balls into the box, and you know, I look in there, Jason's in there with three defenders, and there's not a midfield player or supporting player to be seen. in the second half and the last, particularly last half hour, we're playing balls forward. We've got five people in the box, you know, and it's not acceptable. Yeah. You know, and in a way, I mean, it sounds ridiculous because we've had a really good run. I think, you know, when we counted a couple of friendlies in there, but we've lost one in eight and we looked decent. But I felt the other night, after we went 3-0 up against Waltham Abbey, we basically started defending how we did in the first half, and it's been a big lesson for us. A big lesson for me, because I've got players in there that are not good enough. You know, they're not right for us. And obviously losing a couple of defenders, you know, but the performances of people that I would have expected better of is, you know, it's just not acceptable. And we've been dragged back in it. We worked really, really hard to get a bit of leeway with Romford, and we've been dragged back in it. And the good thing, we've got a week to prepare for Hornchurch next week, and there will be, you know, there will have to be changes, because how we are at the moment, we're not strong enough. And I've said to Rambo, I said that there's sometimes when you get a game like that where you've been taught a lesson in the first half, you use it as a positive, because it highlighted some of the doubts in my mind, and we'll have to deal with it. But,
I mean, I know Chris spoke to Chris a few times. I mean, he's quite pleased now, the uplifting form from Abley now, and they seem to be going in the right direction as well. And but as you said before, we started, we don't seem to be moving up that table. We just seem to be stuck where we are.
Yeah, I mean, it's the first thing we check every week to see if we've climbed or we haven't. We stay in 19 every week. But I mean, that's crazy. They've had a good run, and we've had 7 league games now, won 5 and drew 2. One of my biggest concerns was that we were only going to be strong at home, because we've got lovely pitch, lovely facilities. When we go away, how would we fare away? But now we've gone to Dereham, got a point, Potts Bar got 3 points, Mildenhall got 3 points. So we're starting to find a good balance now, home and away, and we're doing really well. Yeah. But the boys are working hard on the training ground, and it's all coming together at the moment, so it's good.
Yeah, well, we wish you guys all the very best.
This will be a playoff game next season.
You reckon, yeah?
Yeah,
that's what we reckon. Yeah. Well, you in charge. Funny enough, I had somebody coming, as you know, I actually worked just around the corner from the Chesham Ground. And we had a customer come in the other day, and I think one of our boys plays one of the youth sides and comes every Saturday to watch the team. Walked in, and she said she was very desolate and all the rest of it, because she was talking about it. She was going in on a blue paper, and I said, you've got nothing to be desolate about. And I don't know if you agree with me when I say this, but when this young man goes in and goes into a team and whatever else, there is absolutely no chance whatsoever. And I said live on Cambria that the Chesham won't be where they are. They're still in the north or whatever division it will be next year, because this guy is phenomenal, and he turns teams around on any.
But that hurts. I say getting done like that hurts, and hopefully, you know, we'll learn from it, and we'll be hurt by it, and we'll bounce back a bit stronger. But I was pleased that he rallied a bit the second half, but like I say, the game was over as really as a contest.
Well, I've got a couple of presentations for you. As you know, there you go. But these are the trophies that, as you know, Craig, we do the team of the week on the Mid-Kent Metals This Moon show, and on week 25 was Chesham. So congratulations to Chesham, yourself, Dean, and everybody there. And then the funny enough, first two times we've been nominated, and we actually won 2 weeks in a row. So there we go, week 26.
Thank you very much.
And week 27. So congratulations.
Cheers.
To Abel.
Thank you very much, Greg. Cheers.
All done, mate. All done.
But guys, I wish you all the very best, especially you, Craig, as well, for the rest of the season. Thanks for watching, Dave.
Cheers.